Good afternoon, everyone. So my name is Meeral, and today I'll be taking Nolex on error handling in Scala using either T, that is either transformers provided by CATS. So let's first go through Nolex etiquette. Respect Nolex session timings. You're requested not to join session after a 5 minute threshold post the session start time. Make sure to submit a constructive feedback for all sessions as it is very helpful for the presenter. Keep your mobile devices in silent mode. Feel free to move out of session in case you need to attend an urgent call. Avoid unwanted chit-chat during the session. So let's begin the session. So today I'll be covering all of these topics. Either, a brief about either. Either with other effectful types. Either transformers. Basic conversions that are used in either transformers. And a demonstration to show the use cases of all. So, either. In simple terms, either is a value of one of two possible types. Basically, it gives you a leverage to return two types in one value. So mostly, either is used for error handling. And as you can see that either is a very good alternative for options. As in option, we have some and none. In either, we have two options, left or right. So either we can choose left way or either we can go for the right. In options, we have none, which does not give us any response back. But in either, we have a leverage that we can specify what response we want to give in case we want we don't have the right value. Okay, so let me demonstrate to you how we use either for error handling. Is the code visible? Now? Yeah. So over here we have a program, division program, that takes two values that are in string, which we pass into double and then divide. So if you can see the return types of pass, double and divide method, they are either of string or double. That is, if we are able to pass the method, we return the actual value in right, but if we are not able to, we return the response that we want to return in left side of the either. Similarly, we have divide method, that if division is not possible when denominator is zero, we return left response, otherwise we return the actual divided value. These methods are used inside the division program to accumulate the result that you actually want. One sec. Yeah, so the result of the above cases was that if we were able to divide the values, we got 2 in the right wrapper. But if we were not able to, as in the second case our denominator was 0, we got the response in left wrapper saying cannot divide by 0. Whereas in the third case, our number was not divisible, convertible to double. That's why we got the response, A is not a number. So this is a basic example of using either for error handling. But what if you want to use either with other effectful types? By that what I mean is, if the same scenario is converted to become asynchronous. So if you'll see over here, these are the same methods as above, as before, but now they are wrapped inside future. So now they have become asynchronous. Previously, if you had seen that our division program used for comprehension and was quite readable, but currently the procedure that we are using requires us to do flat map. Even if you would have used for comprehension here, it would have been a little complex. It would have included our error logic inside business logic. The complexity increases, the readability is also decreasing, and another thing is that the boilerplate code has been increased. As if you can see that over these last two lines, we are doing nothing. We are just returning the left value again wrapped in future. These are some of the issues that are encountered when we convert, when we use either with any other effectful type. As we are not, as now it's not that convenient as it was when it was used previously. So let's, these are the issues that I previously mentioned. A large amount of boilerplate code is required to handle errors. Program logic is mixed with error handling. Code gets messy and readability decreases. These were the issues that we encountered. Any questions? So hopefully we are on the same page. So to solve these issues, either transformers comes into the picture. Either transformers is nothing, but it's a wrapper for an either which is wrapped inside any other type, effectful type. So if you will see over here, we have the definition says itself that instead of using an either wrapped inside an effectful type, we have an either T which intakes three parameters. First is the type constructor that the either was wrapped into. Second is the left value, and third is the right one. So instead of using either inside wrapped inside effectful type, we can use either T to make our code more readable and easier to function. So let's see the previous code that we used with either using either T. This is the same code that we saw previously, but now we are using either T instead of either. So either T, what is done is, what it does does is that it takes a either wrapped inside a future currently and creates an either T which have three parameters. First is the wrapper, another one is the left value, and the third one is the right value. And now you can easily use for comprehension to do the same code as you used for either. So it makes your code more readable. The complexity of writing the code which we encountered before while using asynchronous methods has been gone, and it's more clear that what is happening over here, and our error logic is not included in the business logic. So let's see the result when we use either T. So it's the same result. Everything is functioning the way it was before, but now it's more clear. So either T is a lightweight wrapper for either wrapped inside another effectful type that makes it easy to compose eithers and ifs together. The basic methods that either T provides are, first the either T constructor is used to convert a either wrapped in another type to for creation of either T, and a dot value method is a value method is used to get the actual either from the wrapper. So let's go through some basic conversions in either T, and I'll demonstrate their uses eventually in the demo. So these are the major used conversions that are actually used while using either T. So either T dot left T and either T dot right T are those methods that are used to encapsulate any value into either. So over here, if you see, we have a number 5, and we have encapsulated it to either T by specifying the wrapper, that is the option, and the error response, that is the left type string. Similarly, for the left T, we have specified the wrapper and the right side. There are other methods also, like either T dot left and either T dot right, which are used to generate either T while you have the wrapper and the value itself, and you only need to specify the alternate value. One of the most common methods is from either, which is used to convert an either into an either T by providing the default wrap, by providing the wrapper in which you want to wrap the either into. So here we have wrapped the either into either T into list and converted it into either T. Similarly, we have that for options also. So for options, it's one of the most common use cases that while we work for options, we mostly have match cases that if the value is present, we'll perform this, and if the value is not present, we'll do something else. So over here, we have a method called from option, which provides a default value that you want to give in case that the option does not contain any value. So if my option has none, I can provide a default value that I want to send inside the either as a left parameter. These all use cases will be demonstrated in the demo that I'm just about to give. Are we on the same page till now, or anyone has any doubts? Okay, so as we are, so let's start. So I have two entities. One second. Account, and another is a user. These two entities are being used for two services, account service and user service. Yeah, sure. It's fine. Is it visible now? So I have an account service that creates an account. This is the major method that we are going to use, is register. What it does is that it validates the password. Now, validate password is just nothing that if any validation we need to provide to validate the passwords, like the length, the maximum length or something like that. So over here we're validating the password, and if the password is not validated, we return invalid password. This method returns either of account service and unit. Let me first tell you what account service error is. So my service has been decomposed into two parts. First is my class account service, which has my methods, and I have created account service error object inside the account service object that has all the error responses that my service could generate. It is one of the ways of using either T when you actually use it in a real project. So these are all the error responses that my particular service will provide, and their name are self-sufficient to respond back to the users. So if my password is not valid, I give invalid password error. Otherwise, I create the account, I fetch that account from the DB again, and if I don't get that account, I get account not found error. This is the whole composition of this method register. And if I'm able to do them, then I'll get then my account gets created and it is returned back. So over here you'll see all the methods that we have used. Over here we have used from either method, which takes validate password as a method, which intakes gives us either, and we have wrapped it into future. This second method, create account, is already giving us future of account name. That is basically future of string, and we have explicitly specified the error response, that is the left side that we want to give. So in either t.write gives us a liberty to specify the left side if we have already specified the wrapper and the actual value. Then we have from option F method, that is the method that gives you the liberty to specify the error response in case the option is none. So that if your option does not have any value, you get account not found error over here. And in this case, the wrapper has been provided by get account method itself. So if you'll see, get account method in turn returns us in future of option. So the wrapper is future, and the error response is account not found, that is an account service error type, and then the actual right value is your account. So this is the whole, the either T that we actually get over here is future, account service error, and account. And eventually we yield the account from it. So let's see the result type of result. So if you'll see, our result is an either T, which intakes three types. First is future, the wrapper that we have provided. Another is account service error, the left side that our either will provide. And then account, that is the actual value that would be resulted from this whole comprehension. Then we have used value method of either T to extract future of either accounts, future of either from either T. So our return type is future of either of account service error of account. This is how we have used either T over here. Let's first see how we can use it. One second. Now if you see over here, I have used register method of account service error, which intakes a name and a password. And if you remember, in our register method, we have a method in to validate the password. Which checks the password length should be greater than 5 or equal to 5. So in our case, as the length was 3, it returned invalid password. So the response that we got was left of invalid password. So this was simple that we had only one service using either T. Now in our actual use cases, we have multiple services and which actually communicate with each other. So what if we have a user service which has a method register to register a user which internally calls account service method to register the account of the user. In this case, if you'll notice, the error, the either returned by register has account service error as left side, which will not be the same for register method of user service as we'll have the corresponding user service error for it. So to communicate these things or to make it visible, either T provides us with many different methods. And one of them that we can use is left map. So the left map method of either t takes the left value of a particular either and creates and in turn gives you liberty to return your own error response. So while registering the user over here, we'll first register, create the account, and once the account and the response is given to us, we'll map the left side of the either to the error response that we want to give. So in our case, we have account registration failed, which is an error response of the user service error. So using this, we can incorporate multiple services and their error responses without any issue. So let's see how we'll use this. So in this case, we didn't get any error, and our user was created without any difficulties. But what if? Now we have reduced the password length, and now we are getting account registration failed error. So you'll notice this check was not done in user service; it was done in account service. And when we got an error an either with left response from account service, we mapped it into account registration failed error response of user service. To left map over here. Any doubt? So this is how we actually use either T while communicating with multiple services and actually handling error. If in these cases we would have used either, it would have made our code a lot complex, readability would have increased, and there are many other things like that either T provides, and we won't be able to do that with either. Like this code is currently very short and readable, but while doing the same with either would have made this a lot complex, and even for using options also, it would have created, it would have made us to do matches to check whether the value is contained or not. So these all functionalities incorporate together in either T, and we are able to write a code that is far much readable, simpler, and of good quality. So these are my references. These blocks are actually very good if you want to start, and either T is one of the practices that I think would make your code more readable and of good quality. Thank you. Either T belongs to CATS. It's a part of CATS library. Yeah. Any other questions?